place. Do you know that there was a purpose for Goliath to come up and run? I'll explain that. If that is only to catch the man, I'm okay. I don't want to spend more than 25 or 30 minutes. There is a man that God has prepared, and God was about to introduce him. And for God to introduce David, a Goliath must come up and mess up. Because if the Goliath does not mess up, David will not be produced. Because David has been anointed so many years ago and has been prepared to be the king, something must happen for him to get to the throne. Something must happen for him to be introduced. Something must happen for people to begin to talk about him. Something must happen for the history to change. Am I talking to somebody? There is somebody here tonight. God has anointed you so many years ago, but there's an opportunity for you to be introduced. And that opportunity is because the enemy, the Goliath in your life, has been making noise. Tonight you are going to conquer that Goliath. And in conquering that Goliath, your name shall be introduced. I say your name shall be introduced. I say your name shall be introduced. I say your name shall be introduced. Hello. It is not because you are falling. Who said it? I think it was Matashimolo. He says, don't give up, it is not over. Let me just go forward a little bit. Let me just leave this story for you and go forward. We know David very well. After all this conquering of Goliath and whatsoever, there came a time in the life of David, something happened and he fell. Listen to me. For every champion, for you to get to the throne, there must be a trial on the way. And the way you handle your trial determines your next step. For Joseph, there was a what? A Potiphar's wife. For Joseph, Potiphar's wife was there. And because Joseph refused to sleep with Potiphar's wife, he was captured and was thrown into jail. Listen. There was an evidence that Joseph wanted to rape that woman. Everybody in the city was against Joseph. Hello. If Joseph had slept with that woman, Joseph would have been promoted. If Joseph had slept with that woman, Joseph would have been elevated. Probably he was a slave and was living in the boys' quarters. The mother probably would have brought him out of the boys' quarters and planted him in the main house. Am I talking to somebody? Yeah. If Joseph had agreed with the madam, then as if they were paying him 10 naira, they would have increased from 10 naira to 1 million naira. As long as he continued to service the madam. But compare, oh my God, when Joseph refused, it would have said God has forsaken him. When Joseph refused, it was as if heaven was closed against him. But listen to me, little did they know that the prince in there is the road to the throne. Little did they know that a man that God has made a champion, nobody can fight against him. Little did they know that if God has ordained you, no man can stand against you. Little did they know that a man that is blessed by God, no matter what you do, he will get him. Oh my God, somebody here is designed to succeed. Somebody here is designed to arise and shine. Somebody is designed to be to the top.
Of the Israelites, something did so many extraordinary things. He was so powerful that only he was able to destroy so many armies. But
an ordinary woman was able to disarm him. For every Samson, there must be a Delilah. But look at this. Samson fell. It's not the fight of Samson that I want to dwell upon. But for every champion, there must be a second chance. I fell, oh my God. Then he said, let not my enemy snap at me. Even if I go seven times, I will arise again. Seven is no more perfection. Seven is no more completeness. His angel said, even if he falls, to the extent there is no hope that he will arise again. I don't know what your condition is. We have fallen before, but tonight you are going to arise and shine. I say you will arise and shine. I say you will arise and shine. I fed yesterday, it is not going to be today. That was yesterday's story. It's not today's story. Something fell. Baby, that came at a time that the hair of Samson grew again. And Samson went back to God. He said, God, forgive me for an error. I have revealed the secret. He said, but Papa, give me a second chance. For the fact that there is champion, God is going to give you a second chance. I said, God will give you a second chance. I said, God will give you a second chance. And in your second chance, you're going to destroy all your enemies in Jesus' name. Also, the story of David. At the time of David's home, David fell. And the backyard of Bathsheba. Hello. And then there came the prophet. Say, David, you have committed adultery. And according to the law, you will be stoned to death. David said, okay, I agree. I committed adultery. The prophet said, yes. He said, but against whom did I sin? He said, against me. So, okay, I know this God. David went up to the law. He said, have mercy upon me. According to your loving kindness, according to the multitude of your tenderness, blot out my transgression. Against you, you only have I sinned. And don't this evil in your sight. He said, great in me, O Lord, a clean heart, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, O Lord. Restore unto me the joy of your salvation. Before David will finish talking to this God, because he knows how to talk to this God. He knows how to come to the throne of grace, whereby he obtains mercy. He knows his God one on one. Before he will finish talking to this God, God looked at David and said, David, I cannot see your sin again. Before you enter to this throne, you are a sinner. But this moment, you are righteous. God will never say, David, you have fallen, I know. But rise up, clean yourself, come up to the workforce, because your end will be greater than your beginning. Listen to the God has to tell you. No matter what has happened before, that was yesterday. No matter where you have fallen, that was yesterday. No matter what you have lost, that was yesterday. But God has to tell you somebody, you are about to rise and shine. I say you are about to rise and shine. I say you are about to rise and shine. Your yesterday might not be palatable, but that is yesterday. Your yesterday might not be very good, but that was yesterday. But your today shall be greater than your yesterday. My God, my God, my God, am I talking to somebody tonight? God has to tell somebody, for the fight and a champion, you are about to conquer. For the fight and a champion, you are about to shine. For the fight and a champion, God, your today shall be better. I say your today shall be better. I say your today shall be better. I say your today shall be better. I was discussing with somebody yesterday. Was it yesterday? Yesterday, my mom was yesterday. I was talking about some particular man of God. And I made just that, I don't know if you have read this, but they call Heroes of Faith. If you read Heroes of Faith, you come to understand that all the heroes of faith have one butt on the body. That will make you to know that they are men of God, they are not spirits of God. And as a man, there will come a time in your life that you behave like a man. You are not a spirit. Am I talking to somebody tonight? Listen, we are ordinary, but when God puts his extra, it's not ordinary, it becomes extraordinary. We are natural, but when God puts his super into our natural is Lord. Tonight, you have a weapon that is greater than any other weapon. When David was brought out, they tried to have an ordinary shine, ordinary war. And let us equip him the way they used to equip ordinary people. They gave him the cato, they gave him the sword of Saul, they gave everything to protect him. But when David looked at it, he tried it, he could not move his leg. Because the things that took heavy on him, he said, no, I have not fought this one before. I cannot fight with this. This one limits me. This one will not move forward. I have a better weapon. The Bible says, the weapon of our warfare are not. Can I say they are mighty to God, to the pulling down of strongholds. He said, they are not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness in the high places. And for the fact that you have parted from the winning side, tonight you will overcome. I say you will overcome. I say you will overcome. I say you will overcome. If you believe that, shall you believe it? He says, take this thing off me. Listen to me. God does not fight the way men fight. When God wanted to deal with Pharaoh, probably they thought that it was by ordinary power, because they know. I will send Omani. I don't know what they call Omani in English. What is Omani in English? I will send Omani. Omani is God's own army to fight Pharaoh. Hello? If God has sent ordinary men, probably Pharaoh would have overcome. But God said to send his own trained army. When the Omanis finish their own battle, said, I will send strong. Look at the war. How many of you, if I've been in the army before, they will say, they will plan the war. And I say, the God of God came to shake them from the air. And after the air has stopped, there was a fight between Israel, when they were talking about the camp of Gaza. They said, we're going to use the air assault. After the air assault, they're going to put the infantry to go now and take over the whole place. That was the way God planned it. He said, let us send the war. The war has had the air assault. That's what I used to try. After he sent them to deal with Pharaoh, and before Pharaoh could say, check with him, he sent his crown and assaults, his infantry and his force. When he fought the Pharaoh, he said, Pharaoh knew how to fight man, he does not know how to fight for. Pharaoh knew how what to, he can shoot bullet and touch a man, but where will shoot bullet and touch a frog?
Am I talking to somebody?
Listen, now I've said one word.